All right, let's talk about how to find interproximal clinical attachment loss. So what you do is you're going to take your probe depth interproximally, and you're going to read your number, which we're going to put it at a number 5 right there. Okay, then what you need to do is you're going to bring your probe up just a little bit, and you need to find where the CEJ is interproximally. You might feel a little jump or a little diffit, or if you go a little bit more subgingival, you might be able to feel the cementum versus the enamel. That's how you know where that junction is. So you take your probe down and you find that CEJ, which on this tooth is about right here. And I'm gonna say that there's about 1 millimeter of tissue above the CEJ. So I'm then going to subtract 5 minus 1, and I have 4 millimeters of clinical attachment loss. So that means this patient has some type of periodontal disease going on, periodontitis.